Now we'll study an important point about nuclear fission, which is nuclear fission is always an induced reaction. Here we can write that the nuclear fission is not a spontaneous phenomena like radioactivity in which we have studied that a nucleus spontaneously disintegrates into lower weight nuclei by emission of radioactive radiation. In a fission, it is not a spontaneous phenomenon. Spontaneously, it does not occur. We can also write that to split a heavy nucleus, we need to externally induce the reaction by injecting a particle into it. Basically, in nature, the nuclei which are available, which are heavy nuclei, they are unstable, but not as such that these will directly disintegrate into middle weight fragments. Heavy nuclei are radioactive, so gradually by the phenomena of radioactive series, these nuclei achieve stability. For sudden splitting or disintegration of a nucleus into two or more middle weight nuclei, we need to induce the reaction. Like you can see this realistic situation that we are given with a nucleus X, in which when externally a neutron is fired into it, then neutron with some kinetic energy, in various cases the value of kinetic energy may be more or less. When a neutron is fired into the nucleus and as soon as it is injected into the nucleus become unstable, and after a very short duration due to the imbalance of internal forces by injection of this neutron, the nucleus is split into two or more, like in this situation, it splits into two middle weight fragments and a few neutrons are also emitted in the surrounding. So, this is the way how a fission reaction is induced. A nucleus never disintegrates into two or more elements spontaneously. It is always done by injection of an external particle like which we have seen here in this situation.